We're here at Mackey Stadium in electrifying Reno, Nevada. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. Mohammed from the seven. Oh, he got nailed on that one. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Almost intercepted there.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. Hands off up the middle and stuffed.
That is just a great play getting into the backfield. This guy is so quick that the ball carrier never had a chance.
He's in trouble, and he is drilled at the 21. After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Moore, the return man. He's tackled at the 42. The Boilermakers and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. When you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job as an offensive staff of putting together a good plan. And I'm sure we're going to see it again today.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 42. Quick throw to the back, it's incomplete. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Going long. No, incomplete. And there wasn't anyone in the vicinity.
I think the ball just slipped out on him.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it. From their own 20-yard line, second down. Wide open, and he just drops it. So the offense fails to pick up a first down.
And now they should come away with pretty good field position. So consider that a big stop.
Moore is back awaiting the punt. Tries to get around the corner. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Tackle made at the 44. from the 44-yard line. It's second down. Looking for his man, incomplete. Around the 16-yard line.
The offense caught him flat-footed to convert that third and long. You can tell by the coach's reaction that that is a huge disappointment.
And they make the stop around the 7-yard line. One away. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Myers quickly to the fullback.
They chose to throw the ball here on third and short, and it proved effective as the little dump pass got them a new set of downs.
For a loss.
Hold this.
Goes to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete. It's the ninth play of the drive. To the halfback, touchdown. And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 43-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. So our score, 7-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Christian from the two. And down he goes at the 22-yard line. Purdue's looking awfully impressive right now in defense, but we are in the first quarter.
Yeah, this is about as dominant a first quarter that we have seen in a long time. But let's see if they can continue to play this well throughout the rest of the ballgame.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 22. Moves up in the pocket and down he goes. No good. Moore back deep to return. Moore takes it at the 45, brought down at the 39. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Purdue up 7 points. He's taken down at about the 41. So it's second and 12. Ball on the 41. He's going to try and scramble. He's at the 30, dives forward. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
Has time. Deep ball, laying it out there. He's got it. Touchdown, Boilermakers. And he hits the PAT. A short three-play, 39-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. So the score now, 14-0. They line up to kick this one away. Muhammad fields it at the 7. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
Purdue's got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
The offense will be hoping for a little more success than they had the last time out.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Quick release, tight end, incomplete. Second and 10, ball on the 27. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it. A screen pass, gets it to the back, and he's taken down at the 34. The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. And he muffed it.
He was definitely peeking to see what kind of space he had to run. And that loss of focus is what cost him.
The offense will come out again hoping to have similar results as their last drive.
And it was a really nice drive too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
They'll knock him down for a loss. Second down at 12. Ball on the 29. Strike and he drops it. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
Can't hold on. From their own 46-yard line, it's second down. Throws out and through his hands. Down and he's out of bounds. And they pick up the first down with a pass to the tight end.
It's easy to forget about the tight end sometimes coming off the line, but you always have to watch this guy because he's certainly capable of making big plays.
Plenty of time in the pocket. He airs it out. What a play, and that'll set up a first and goal. The tight end came up with a nice catch that time.
Yeah, the big fella's pretty athletic for a tight end, and as a quarterback, it's always nice to have a big target like this to go to.
And he tackles him hard at the 5-yard line. Tries to buy some time. Breaks one and scores. And really a nice run there by that quarterback.
Well, great decision by the quarterback reading the defense, and as soon as he saw the open field, he cut it upfield and scored the touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 9-play, 69-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. The score now, 21-0. Evans has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. Caught at the 8. He makes it to the 28-yard line. They need to show a little giddy-up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. He's on the run. He's to the 40. And they push him out around the 43-yard line. Good yardage there on the scramble.
Well, you have to credit the quarterback here. He's not the most fleet-footed guy on the field, but notice how he has the awareness and the composure to know when to tuck it and go. And as a result, he comes up with a big play.
From their own 43-yard line. Second down. At the 48.
That's where you fly to the ball.
Trying to change the field position with his kick. It's away. Short punt. The Boilermakers really could have overlooked this team today, I think, very easily, but they haven't done that so far.
No, you can't take anybody too lightly, and they've obviously not done that. They come out of the gate today and really putting a lot of points up on the board.
The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
They'll bring him down at the 36.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instincts.
Goes to his back, and it's in and out of his hands. From their own 36-yard line, it's third down. Fires it out. He's tackled at the 42-yard line. We're through one quarter. Purdue's got a 3-touchdown advantage. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Hand off inside. Brought down around the 36-yard line. Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 36-yard line. And they'll get him in the backfield.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Moore awaiting the return. He's tackled at the 31, and he didn't get anything on that return.
Well, the coverage team did an outstanding job at containing here. You always see this with this team. They're very disciplined on special teams.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Setting up play action. Dumps it right to his fullback. Tackle at about the 37-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Up the middle for a nice game. Made at the 40. Play action. Good protection. Going deep. Lays it out there. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. He fights forward to about the 7. From the 7-yard line, second down. He dives and he'll be marked down. And he's tackled at the 3-yard line.
The defense needs to be careful. The safety might have made that play, but if he keeps coming up on the run, there'll be space downfield for the pass.
This isn't much more than an extra point. He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. Purdue to kick this one off. Gathered in at the 6. He's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 32. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. At the 40. Quick out to his receiver.
And they make the stop
right around the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line, it's second down. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. He lets it fly. Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Purdue's offense really had a goal in that first quarter, but they're starting to struggle here in the second hurry.
Well, because they played so well early in this game, even though they have been struggling, they still have a pretty comfortable lead. Now let's see if they can hold on to it here as we get ready for the second half.
It's still only the second quarter. We got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Nice run up the middle.
Check, tight right. Solo out there, check the outs out there. Alert.
Fakes to the back. Throws to the tight end, and that falls incomplete. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Fires out to his wideout, and he hits him hard at the 48-yard line. His man incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 48. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
From the 41-yard line, second down. He heaves it deep. No, incomplete. Here's the eighth play of the series. They'll spread the field with five wide. Has it to the senior. And he's taken down around the 31-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. He's at the 20. Makes it to the 14.
What is going on with his defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
About 2 minutes before halftime. Again with a carry. Good outside run there. Scrambling. And down he goes around the 5-yard line. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. It's up, and it's through the uprights. Purdue lines up for the kickoff. He'll return it from the six. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt.
This offense needs to start playing some emotional football.
He goes out of bounds at the 30. Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 30. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Goes out to the running back, no good.
That's a miscommunication between a quarterback and a wide receiver right there. They need to get their signals straight.
Moore is back deep to return. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. The Boilermakers are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
I'm really surprised how lopsided this first half has been. But this is college football, and no matter what the score is, the adrenaline's always pumping on both sides. Just throws this one away. From their own 43-yard line, it's second down. Purdue in control. Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands. Here's a quick throw. Purdue's going to have to use their second time out of the half. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 31-yard line.
Mike 7. Mike 7.
There's a very impressive open field tackle.
Any offense is predicated on being able to move efficiently like this.
It's up. Looks long enough. And he splits the uprights. They're probably just going to squib this kick. I don't think they want to see the return man create lightning before halftime. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They couldn't get anything going on that last drive.
I don't know what these guys have to do to get back on track, but they need to try something.
They'll work the left side. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. And that'll bring the first half to a close. Folks, it's been a little more lopsided than we thought. 30 to nothing, Purdue.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. I really hope you'll stick around and watch the second half of this game. During the second half, I expect Kirk Herbstreit to give us a comprehensive history of every playbook he's ever had in his entire football career, dating back to Pee Wee. That would be infinitely more interesting than having to watch the second half of this blowout.
Definitely, That would be probably more entertaining. We get on games all the time. They start to get out of hand. You got to empty the bucket. So, guys, back to you. Have some fun. Tell me something I don't know. These teams are pretty boring.
Give me something from the human interest file, Brad Nessler. Looking forward to seeing this second half. I think there's certainly a want for victory.
A want and a need for victory. Some teams need this victory, Reese Davis.
Want, need, got to go get it either way. Brad and Kirk are there to deliver.
Reese, David, wish you were here instead of Kirk and I. We start the second half in this lopsided ball game. And down he goes at the 35-yard line.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of it.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. You can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin, and they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio with the best seat in the house. Belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Purdue comes to the line holding that commanding lead. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line.
That is exactly the type of play that good linebackers make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, you're probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. He's tackled right around the 46-yard line. Hit before it can go anywhere. It's first and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Down at the 4-yard line.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Watch the pass. Defense and their short yardage package.
Run.
Looking for the corner on the run, right side.
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
He makes the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Muhammad takes it from the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Purdue's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Oklahoma!
On the throw, incomplete pass. From their own 30-yard line. Second down.
Watch his flat. Hey, check Mike 46.
Zips it to the back. And he's leveled the 39-yard line. carries the ball for a nice game. For 6 points here. Throws to the back quickly, off his hands, incomplete. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Wanted his receiver. The defense has really held their own the last two plays. Now it's 3rd and goal from the 7. Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. He's pushed out of bounds, right around the 2-yard line. A gain of 6.
And I thought this play was going to go for more yards, but the defense did a good job of shutting it down before the halfback could get any further downfield.
He gets it up, and it splits the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Caught at the 8. Brought down at the 26-yard line.
The Boilermakers had that hot hand on offense, and they just keep on going here in quarter number 3.
The greatest thing you could say about these guys today is consistency. They are moving the football and putting points up on the board. They're going to be tough to beat.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it.
I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
So it's 2nd down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the 1st down. He's scrambling.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Purdue with a commanding lead. Up the middle for a nice game. And they make the stop at the 49-yard line. From the 49-yard line, 1st down. And he's tackled at about the 37-yard line. Fires. He can't hang on. Incomplete. Me, 2nd down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Wide open. Incomplete. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Couldn't haul it in. And so now the ball's turned over on downs. Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose.
And two.
He's taken down at the 49. He's under some heat. He passes it. He got a hand on it, but it's incomplete. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 49.
Hey, check Mike 46. Check Mike 46.
Ready!
Throws it in a hurry. And he's taken down at the 34-yard line. To his tight end. And down he goes around the 30-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. And they got him. Third down, and they need to get it to the 24.
Roger, Roger. Hey, check Mike 46. Check Mike 46.
Once and all, going deep. Almost intercepted. He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. This senior quarterback's put on a good show, Kirk.
Well, Brad, you just said it. He's a senior quarterback, and that experience is so important. It allows you to just sit back and comfortably read the defenses and then eventually find the man that's open and deliver the football.
Really no surprises in this game. He's played well, his teammates have played well, and they're in the driver's seat. They're set to go for another round. Purdue, up by a bunch. And he is drilled at the 18. Second down and 7. Ball on their own 18. 5 wide. Quick out to his receiver. They'll bring him down at the 26. Makes it to the 28-yard line. From their own 28-yard line. Second down. That's 3 down and 1 to go. Purdue's running away with it. This one has been a blowout since the beginning. Hopefully the fourth quarter will turn things around. Has some daylight. Makes it to the 41. From their own 41-yard line.
First down. Gets to about the 41-yard line. Purdue up big. Caught out of the open.
These short, effective passes are going to help the quarterback's confidence.
From their own 45-yard line, third down. And he tackles him hard at the 34. He makes it to the 35-yard line. Kirk, this defensive lineman has made a statement with his play tonight.
Well, he's just one of those defensive players that if you're an offensive coordinator, you're basically building your game plan around his skills. I think it has a lot to do with the way they're pressuring the quarterback. They're just doing a great job as a unit and not allowing this quarterback to get into any rhythm.
Well, all of his good plays have added up to his team enjoying the lead. I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. Watch out here. He's tackled at the 46-yard line. Caught with room to work. And he hits him hard at the 39. He throws it. Incomplete. From the 39-yard line. Second down.
Hey, check my 46. Check my 46.
Here we go. Green flag.
With the pass, incomplete.
Here's one the quarterback would like to rewind because he has a wide open receiver and he just misfires.
Incomplete. So they're going to go for it here. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Brought down at the 31-yard line. Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Purdue looking to put this game away if they score here. And he's sacked. They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long. He airs it out. And it's caught. There he goes. To the 20. The 10. Touchdown, Purdue. Make it three passes for touchdowns.
What I'm noticing more and more about this guy is he's very patient with the ball, and it's resulting in some nice scores, just like we've seen today.
Converts the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays. Get to that quickly. He's tackled in the open field. Makes the catch and look out. And he's level at the 39-yard line. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 39.
Hey, check Mike 46. Check Mike 46.
Looks left, finding his tailback. Tackle around the 46-yard line. Makes it to the 44.
On that play, he didn't have too much time to react to that pass.
From the 44-yard line, it's second down. Tackle made at the 29. Throws this one away. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. That's a great tackle at the 19. Decent pickup.
Get out, get out, get out. Check three, check three. Check three, check three.
And they make the stop at about the 7-yard line. Of the current drive.
Roger, Roger. Hey, check by 46. Check by 46.
Ready.
Throws and it's incomplete. Let's see how the quarterback handles this one. It's third and goal from the 7. Tackled at the 7.
Hey, we got tied right. Three down. Hey, check.
Ready. Easy. Big dog.
Well, they're not going to win it, but they're still playing hard out there. He stepped up and threw a touchdown pass to his wideout.
Yep, good job of protection, and the quarterback spotted his man.
You talk about a clutch play. They couldn't afford any mistakes on fourth down there. And he tacks on the extra point. Bring him down at the 43. Purdue's staff and their fans got to be happy this guy's on their side.
Well, with him making plays the way he did today, there's reason for their optimism and the reason they feel good about having him on their side.
They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession.
I expect him to run the ball, kill the clock, and put this one in the books.
From the 38-yard line, it's second down. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Gets to about the 37-yard line. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. For the corner. Well, a nice stop there late in the fourth quarter, but this game, quite frankly, has been over for a long time, and I'm ready for it to end. The punter is going to try to pin them deep in their own territory with a good punt here. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Well, late in the fourth quarter, this game has been over for a long time, and now we just want to get out of here like these two teams do. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. From their own 20-yard line, second down. Quickly incomplete. A little over a minute in the game. He's out to the 30. He's taken down at the 30-yard line. Taken down at the 40-yard line. They go back to him on a quick throw. And down he goes around the 47-yard line. Hit before it could go anywhere. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. They'll bring him down right around the 22-yard line. For more. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Here's play number 10 on the drive. We've got second and goal. 8 yards out. They got him for a loss. sure they won't win it, but they haven't quit yet.
Tremendous example of the type of chemistry that these two players enjoy. When a quarterback and a receiver are on the same page, good things tend to happen.
He makes the PAT. So an 11-play, 79-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school, grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
Brought down at the 45-yard line. You just hope that a game this uneven ends quietly. We don't want to see anything nasty and pointless at the end. Purdue in control. Makes it out to about the 33. The Boilermakers know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance, and really the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
So that wraps things up for us. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.